Hi guys, I'm Chef Mollie, Farmer Mollie, depends on what hat I'm wearing. And this is our CSA box. We're doing this box as a collaboration with Ayala Farms in Oxnard and our farm here in Fillmore. There's certain things they can grow that I can't grow, and there's certain things I can grow that they can't grow. And so this gives an opportunity for us to both put the fruits of our labor into one box that gets delivered right to your door. And we've been getting a lot of questions on Instagram. How much food is it? I'm only two people. Can I eat it all? And so I'm gonna unpack this box and let you guys see what we have, give you some tricks and tips as to how to make the food last and get the best use out of everything that you have. So Swiss chard is what I would say something you wanna use it as soon as possible. I would say it only has like a 2-day shelf life, 3 maybe maximum. But if it starts to get a little wilty, just chop, chop, chop and blanch it in a little bit of boiling water and put it in a Ziploc bag in your freezer, maybe with a little salt. And then you can use it anytime you're making pasta, making a stir fry, making fried rice, making a soup. You just already have emergency vegetables. My mom used to keep one of those bricks of spinach. I don't know if you guys remember when bricks of spinach came. That was our emergency vegetables in the freezer. But this could be your emergency vegetables. Kale has a couple more days than Swiss chard. So if you have to eat one of them first, eat the Swiss chard first. Kale, you can either put it in, if you chop the ends off and you put it in water, it will last a few more days. That's a good tip. And you can also just as easily chop this and blanch it and put it in the freezer for later. But, and you can also massage it with a little bit of olive oil and lemon and salt and pepper and put it in the fridge and then make it into salad a few days after that. So that is a couple of different ways that you can make your kale last longer. Nasturtiums, these are not always in the boxes, but they're very fragile. So eat these the first day. They're excellent in salads. You can eat both the leaves and the flowers. So these definitely want to go into the first meal you make with your box. We have a bundle of rosemary here. And rosemary, this is a lot of rosemary. You know, you only need a little branch. So this might be something you wanna hang up in your kitchen and keep using it, and then pick the needles off of it and put it in the Cuisinart or in the blender and blend it all up. And so you can just put it on. This is as much as you would get in a full bottle that you buy at the store, so that's excellent. This is called a spring onion. So if you get an onion and it's still white like this and the green is still on it, it hasn't been preserved and dried out. And so when you preserve an onion and dry it out, you will leave it in the shade and the outer layers of the onion turn into this paper that we're all familiar with that protect your onions. When an onion is like that, you can keep it outside. When an onion is like this, you have to keep it in the refrigerator. So that's good information about that. Tomatoes, I don't believe in putting tomatoes in the refrigerator. So sometimes you might get tomatoes like this, sometimes you might get tomatoes like this, but definitely you wanna leave your tomatoes out on the counter in a bowl. You don't wanna put them in the refrigerator. A lot of people tell me that they don't like tomatoes, and I don't believe that anybody doesn't like tomatoes. They don't like mushy, gross, store-bought tomatoes that were picked green, shipped green, and then gassed to turn red right before they hit the grocery store, and they're all mealy and mushy inside. Well, nobody likes that. But this, a vine-ripened tomato that's imperfect and delicious, everybody likes that. Here's some plums. Those, just eat them right away. You don't even have to worry about how to store them. But you would want to put them out on the counter in a bowl. As well as the citrus, you can put it out in the counter. So we have golden nuggets in this box. We have Valencia oranges. These are excellent for juicing or eating. These are excellent for eating. They're easy to peel. And all the citrus can be left out on the counter in a bowl. All of our citrus may not be perfectly orange. You might see some parts that are still green. That's okay. We don't use any gas for ripening, so it's okay that some of our citrus is not perfectly orange or perfectly yellow. We're growing 4 or 5 different kinds of beans right now, so you may get a little bag of, these are what we call cranberry beans. We also have purple beans, wax beans, and regular green beans. The purple beans do turn green when you cook them. I was very disappointed. I grew them, I was so excited, and the mixed colored beans, and then they all turn green when you cook them. So don't be disappointed, but you might want to consider making them into a raw dish, chopping them up as a little extra crunch in your salad, or using them as a topping to a cooked dish so that they keep their beautiful purple color if you do get purple beans. This is mint. So mint you want to use pretty rapidly. It can go bad. But if you can't use it right away, put it in water. And if you can't use it even for longer, hang it upside down, and it's an awesome tea. This is so delicious, and you can make tea out of it. Or the other option is just boil water, make tea, and put the tea in the refrigerator, and then it will last for almost 2 weeks, your mint tea, in the refrigerator for iced tea. Or another fun thing to do is make a concentrate, boil water with a lot of mint leaves in it, and then strain it out and make ice cubes, and you can have mint ice cubes for mint juleps or some cocktails that have mint in it. Or just mint ice cubes in lemon water is also delicious. So that's a fun thing to do. We have either green or purple cabbage in all of our boxes right now. We will for a little while. You know, cabbage lasts a long time in the refrigerator. So you could put this in there, and if you don't eat this till next week or a week later, it's fine. And if you end up with, let's say you get one box and the next week you get a box and you don't end up eating the cabbage, you end up with two or three heads, you can make sauerkraut, which is awesome, or you can make pickled cabbage if you're not into the fermented flavor, you just want to use vinegar. That's another option. And if you've ever been to my restaurant, Sage, we use half green cabbage and half purple cabbage to get that bright, fluorescent, pink-colored cabbage that we top everything with. And it's a beautiful topping. And once you pickle the cabbage or you kimchi it or you make sauerkraut, you're going to be able to have it for months, 6-7 months in your refrigerator. And cabbages last a long time. So don't worry about eating your cabbage right away, because there's no rush on that. Here we have cucumbers. Cucumbers, they last a few days. They're excellent when they're fresh and crispy. I love this time of year to just do a salad that's just cucumbers, tomatoes, and avocados. Nothing else. No lettuce. Lettuce gets harder to grow the hotter it is outside. So I love using cucumbers in the summertime as your lettuce in your salad instead of lettuce. It's a really delicious, chunky salad. So you can do that one with the tomatoes and avocado, or you can do one with white vinegar and sesame seeds and sesame oil, and do it more like an Asian style cucumber salad. There's so many options for cucumbers instead of lettuce in salads, and that is my favorite thing to do in the summertime. This is bay leaf. So bay leaf is something, we won't put this every week because this is a lot of bay leaf, and you will get it sometimes and not sometimes. But again, this you can dry. You know, if you buy bay leaf in the store, it's just 3 or 4 leaves in a glass jar. This will be like a whole little quart jar of leaves once they dry. So you just hang it and dry it, and then you can use them for cooking soups and cooking beans. And traditionally here in the United States, people put these in black beans, but that started from people that came here from Mexico not having easy access to avocado leaves, which is the traditional in Mexico to put in the black beans, is avocado leaves. But if you go to Mexican restaurants or eat at different places that serve black beans here in the United States, you notice that they put bay leaves in because they don't have access to avocado leaves always. But you never know, you might get avocado leaves in one of our boxes one of these days with a little note from me on how to make black beans Oaxaca style. The next thing we have is avocados. So these avocados are not ripe yet. These are all Haas avocados, and they're not ripe. And what I would like to say about the avocados is you can make them ripen faster or slower. At room temperature, 72 degrees is the best temperature for ripening avocados. If you want them to ripen faster, put them in a warm spot with fruit like bananas, apples, things that are ripening. They will help in a closed paper bag or in a closed box or something sealed. So the gases that are off-gassing from the apples or the bananas can ripen these. Even if you just put a bunch of avocados and you don't have any other fruit, they'll start to off gas and the gases will go back on them, and it will make them ripen faster. So you might want to put a few in a bag and then put a few out on the counter and then put one or two in the refrigerator. And when the first ones get ripe, take the ones out of the refrigerator and leave them on the counter so that you should have avocados in a few days. This is a little jam we have in this one. We're going to be adding value-added products made by Chef Mollie and my husband, Chef Elias, in the boxes. So strawberry jam was this week's value-added product. You can add that to your toast or anything, and this is not going to go bad for a long time. In the cupboard, it could last forever, and if you open it and put it in the refrigerator, it could last for probably 6 months. You just want to keep an eye on it. The most thing that could happen to jam is it could get mold around the top where there's air getting into it. This is beets, and there's two other beets in here. So sometimes we're going to send the beets like this, and sometimes we'll send the beets like this. You should take these greens and chop, chop, and cook them. Here, it's summertime. We have jalapenos. We're harvesting a lot of jalapenos right now. They are spicy because it's hot out. The hotter it is outside, the more spicy they are. A lot of times you might see these big jalapenos and they look like they're gonna be really spicy and then they're really mild. They're probably grown in a greenhouse in a cooler temperature. Jalapenos, they'll last almost a week or more in your refrigerator. If they start to shrivel or something, don't worry about it. Dry chilies are something that traditionally many cultures eat them dry, let them dry in the sun and shrivel up and eat them then. So there's no hurry to eat the chili right away. You just want to make sure that if it is getting a little shriveled, when you open it up, that there's no mold around the seeds. You wouldn't want to eat any mold. Celery is beautiful. Here we have a celery, and this is excellent for making soups, and I think lots of recipes start with onions, carrots, and celery. Lots of soups start with that. If your celery gets a little wilty, like you don't get to it, a great thing to do with it is make a soup stock. So get a big pot, chop it up, put in an onion, and any other like weird pieces of the vegetables you don't use. Let's say you cut off the top of these greens and you don't want to use them, or the bottoms of the cauliflower, the bottoms of broccoli we sometimes have. You put all those little weird pieces of veggies in with some garlic, onions, soy sauce or salt, celery, and you boil it. You could put tomatoes in there, whatever you want. And then you strain out all of the veggies and you can freeze that. And anytime you're ready to make soup, make ramen, make mashed potatoes, you'll have this awesome veggie stock that you can use for anything that you want to make. So I love having a vegetable stock for making curries or anything in my freezer ready to go when I'm ready to cook, because it takes a long time to make a vegetable stock. So I just like to make it one time, a bunch of quarts, and put it in my freezer. Carrot tops, like if you're cutting the carrots off, those are good to go in a vegetable stock as well. Some people just save all the little pieces of veggies they use all week in a bag in the refrigerator and then use that to make a veggie stock. That's an excellent idea. Carrots last a good amount of time. As long as they're still crunchy, they're good. If they get a little wilty, if you leave them in your refrigerator too long and they get like limp, you definitely just only want to eat them cooked. They're not delicious when they're wilty. But a good hack with carrots, if they get a little wilty, you can peel them and cut them up and put them in a little bit of water, cold water in the refrigerator, and they'll perk back up again. So if you got some carrots that got a little wilty, just peel them, cut them for your salad or something, and then leave them in water in the refrigerator for a few hours and they'll get crispy again. Leeks are excellent substitute for onions. You can do potato leek soup. You can do lots of different soups. You can saute them in your breakfast potatoes. You can use them for almost anything. Some people believe you can eat the whole thing. Some people just like this bottom part. That's kind of up to you. This top part can definitely go in your veggie stock if you don't like how they taste. You can use them as onions. You can use them as a green vegetable. Either way, I love putting them in fried rices or stir fries or, you know, any kind of vegetable medley. I love using leeks. I already cooked with part of this cauliflower, so sorry, it's already in half. But cauliflower does not have to be used right away. You definitely have a few days, a few 4, 5, 6 days with cauliflower. What you want to be worried about is if the little edges that might have got bumped when it was getting thrown in the box or something, don't start to get black. And if they do, oops, I stepped on cucumber. If they do, you can just really easily just cut that little part off if it got a little black, and then you can still use it. So I recommend that you don't eat the cauliflower right away, because that can last a pretty long time, and nothing's more delicious than buffalo cauliflower. So you might want to make it the first night because you want some buffalo cauliflower, and I understand that. We should eat the more sensitive things first and eat the more hearty things later. So all that's left in this box is another lemon and another orange, another carrot that got messed up here, and one more lemon. So this is what comes in an average 40-pound box. It's definitely a good amount of food. I think it's a great value, and I think there's lots of different things to do with all of this food. People make cocktails with the citrus. People make cocktails with the rosemary. There's lots of different things, and you could make marmalades with the citruses, and there's so many different things. And what I love about CSA boxes before I was a farmer is it would push me in my culinary comfort zone. Like, I will cook the same stuff over and over and over. But when you're like, oh, I have this big head of purple cabbage, or I got some parsnips or whatever, you may decide to try different things. And that's how you discover new foods that you love, is by trying them. And so what I love about the CSA program is you subscribe and you get different food every week, or sometimes it's the same food for a couple of weeks because that's what the farm has, but you're eating seasonally and you're eating locally and you're eating what's available. And I think that that is an extraordinary way to push outside of your comfort zone of what you're used to eating. That's our CSA box.